Pekka Bagnaia and Jorge Martin face off in a thrilling final round showdown at the Ricardo Tormo Circuit in Valencia.
Look at that, they're scary, you know.
Bagnaia's gone in through the slip road and Jorge's followed him straight in there. This is Martin mind games at play, because Bagnaia running hot there, or deliberately run off circuit at turn eight and going through the dirty part of the circuit, getting dirt and dust on those tyres. Directly behind him was Martin. Bagnaia stays, he only goes at the 14th place. Martin's gone second. There's no dramas for him about a place in Q2. Martin's running so close to the rear tyre of Bagnaia. Yellow flags are out in sector two, and Martin's seen the yellow flags. He knows that he's in Q2.
Wow.
It's over for Bagnaia.
Jorge's laughing his head off in the helmet. He just played it perfect. Like, this is the sort of start to a weekend when you're trying to steal 21 points. This is the sort of start of the weekend you need.
Into Q1, the world champ goes on the most important weekend of the season. Vinales does find a 129.142. There is a history, a record-breaking first 128 out there for somebody. What a performance it's been on Friday the factory Aprilia, man. Now, your fastest rider ever here in Valencia, it's Maverick Vinales. Fabio De Gianantonio, the first rider actually of the weekend that's gone into the 129s. He threatened it late and actually this morning in free practice, but he has managed it this afternoon in the hotter conditions. A 129.805, which is only just over 4 tenths away from Jorge Lorenzo's 7-year-old lap record now from 2016. Binder fires himself up inside the top three on the factory KTM. 129.402 from the South African.
Look at this.
This
see, hard
big
acceleration now, turn two. On its side, close the throttle and...
That was a real nasty crash. It looked like Jack was out on a fresh soft rear tyre.
That was brutal to watch.
Marc Marquez did say yesterday that he doesn't want to say that this is his last ever MotoGP appearance for Honda, because never say never, who knows, maybe in the future he will return to what has been his home for the whole of his MotoGP career. Marc Marquez now up into second place with a 130.13. I wonder what's going through Nadia Padovani's mind, as in just a few days' time, she'll be at the forefront, spearheading an all-Marquez lineup in that Ducati camp next season.
Let's have a quick look at Fabio's bike, because I spotted the bike in the right-hand side of the garage had some fork-mounted wings, which we've never seen on the Yamaha before.
Quartararo will be in Q1 tomorrow morning. What a session that's going to be, one you're not going to want to miss.
If you love MotoGP, like and subscribe, so you don't miss any video.